faster than the fabric of space-time can keep up with it, and it'll just rip. And I'm terrified by it.
A massive celestial event is about to captivate the entire world, and it's happening right above us. Today, we're diving into the mind-bending world of astrophysics as we explore the imminent and awe-inspiring Betelgeuse supernova explosion. Get ready to witness the night sky as you've never seen it before. But when exactly will this happen, and what will it look like? Join us as we uncover the details of what's happening with Betelgeuse and how it might affect Earth and the entire solar system. First, let's get to know Betelgeuse a bit better. It's not your average star. It's a red supergiant, one of the brightest stars in the universe, shining over 100,000 times brighter than our sun. But why does this red giant matter to us? Well, Betelgeuse is special, not only because it's so bright, but also because it has a rich history in human culture. Imagine this. Betelgeuse is so enormous that if it took our sun's place, it would stretch all the way to Jupiter. This cosmic giant is nearing the end of its life, and when massive stars like Betelgeuse reach the twilight of their existence, they don't simply fade away, they go out with a bang, a supernova explosion. This explosion is so incredibly powerful that it's hard for us to even comprehend its energy and brightness. It has the potential to outshine an entire galaxy, casting brilliant shadows across the vast cosmic expanse. The last time Earth witnessed a supernova explosion like this was way back in 1604, long before the invention of modern telescopes. It was called Kepler's supernova and was the last supernova visible to the naked eye in our Milky Way galaxy. It blazed in the night sky for over 18 months, outshining every other star and even being visible during the day. But what's fascinating is that ancient records from various civilizations documented this new star. Even today, with advanced telescopes, we can still observe the remnants of this explosion in the form of an expanding debris cloud. These remnants provide us with insights into the dramatic ends of massive stars. Historically, supernovae, like Kepler's, have been rare events on Earth. Betelgeuse, with its unpredictable dimming patterns, hints that it might be getting ready for such a spectacular show. Now, let's talk about what's been going on with Betelgeuse lately. Astronomers have made a surprising discovery. Between October 2019 and early 2023, something extraordinary happened to Betelgeuse, and it's called the Great Dimming. Betelgeuse, which had been shining consistently for centuries, started to become less bright. This change was so noticeable that even people who casually looked at the stars noticed it when comparing Betelgeuse to other stars in Orion. This dimming means that we might not have to wait for centuries to see its supernova explosion. It could happen in just a few decades or even sooner. By April 2023, astronomers reported that Betelgeuse had gone back to its usual brightness levels, which made many think that the strange dimming was over. But then, in a surprising twist, Betelgeuse's brightness suddenly increased by a whopping 50%.
Until further study, but now it seems to be really brightening, and this is a little more unusual brightening than it normally does. So this could just be another indicator of the final legs of its life.
Such big changes, while common in some stars, were unexpected for Betelgeuse, which usually followed a more predictable brightness pattern. This sudden surge in brightness brought Betelgeuse back into the spotlight and got everyone talking about its future. Betelgeuse has a typical brightness cycle that lasts about 400 days, but this great dimming seemed like it was breaking the rules and challenging what we knew about the stars above. So why did this happen? While the exact cause is still under investigation, scientists propose an intriguing theory. Imagine Betelgeuse as a colossal celestial volcano, suddenly erupting, expelling a massive amount of its material into space. Past observations from the Hubble Space Telescope revealed similar events, with Betelgeuse ejecting an astonishing 400 billion times the usual mass of stars during such occurrences, equivalent to multiple lunar masses. This event created a dense dust cloud around the star, obscuring its brightness temporarily, and as the dust dissipated due to the star's radiation, Betelgeuse returned to its regular luminosity. This could explain recent brightness fluctuations, but Betelgeuse remains a source of surprises. One thing to remember when we look at Betelgeuse is that we're actually looking into the past. Light from stars and celestial objects takes a long time to reach us due to the vastness of space. Betelgeuse is so far away that the light we see from it started its journey 650 years ago. To put that in perspective, when this light began its trip to Earth, it was the time of the Renaissance, and explorers like Marco Polo were making history. Every time we observe Betelgeuse, we're like cosmic time travelers, glimpsing into a distant past. Intriguingly, if Betelgeuse had already undergone a spectacular supernova, we wouldn't know for another 650 years. While we discuss its impending supernova, in the vast cosmos, this remarkable event might have already happened. When Betelgeuse eventually goes supernova, it will be a breathtaking celestial event. Dr. Stanimir Mechov of Western University predicts that it will outshine other stars and possibly even rival the moon in brightness, illuminating our night skies for weeks or months. This spectacular display will transform our perception of the Orion constellation. Astronomers are investigating the potential consequences of this explosion. Some suggest that it might release cosmic rays, creating dazzling auroras as they interact with interstellar material. Fortunately, the distance of Betelgeuse should dilute and absorb these rays, minimizing their impact on Earth. However, our satellites could be affected by the sudden increase in brightness and potential gamma and X-ray radiation, particularly those in higher orbits. Protective measures may be necessary to safeguard our satellite infrastructure. Scientists will also monitor Earth's atmosphere for any effects from increased radiation. Additionally, while space is usually silent, Betelgeuse's explosion could generate fluctuations in charged particles, creating an acoustic signature detectable by instruments sensitive to such phenomena. Neutrinos, nearly massless particles, will reach us even before these sounds, and specialized observatories are poised to detect these early warnings. Regarding extraterrestrial life, planets near Betelgeuse might experience dramatic climate changes, impacting nocturnal species. Radiation from the explosion could reshape ecosystems and influence evolution, particularly on planets lacking protective features like strong magnetic fields. So what happens to Betelgeuse once it dazzles us with its explosive finale? It embarks on a new journey, and what that journey looks like depends on its mass. If its core is sufficiently massive, it could collapse into a black hole, an entity with such gravity that not even light can escape. Conversely, if the core falls short in mass, it may become a neutron star, an incredibly dense object primarily composed of neutrons. Witnessing the birth of either a black hole or a neutron star from Betelgeuse's remnants would be a monumental event in the field of astronomy.